continue to keep people up to date on the work that's been going on in the light of the awful disaster down in London at the Grenfell Tower. Beg the indulgence of Cabinet just to vary the business slightly to just give a report back on the ongoing work that we're doing in Wirral around the properties here. I'm going to ask do I need to do that first? Sorry, before I do that, I just need to, yes, sorry. Thank you for reminding me, sir. Before I do that, I just need to ask members if there are any declarations of interest that anybody wishes to declare. Stuart.
Thank you very much for the elected person of interest.
So, I'm going to ask George Cabinet Member for Housing to just make a statement, please, George, on the latest position on the work we've been doing in the light of the disaster. Thanks, George.
Thanks, Roy. obviously, our thoughts are with all those affected by the tragic events at Grenfell Tower and Mooney. The Council has formed a high-rise coordination group to manage these issues in the light of the terrible events at Grenfell Tower, and is dealing with these matters with the utmost urgency. I am a member of this group to ensure political leadership and oversight as Deputy Leader of the Council and a Cabinet Member for Housing and Community Safety. Along with Joe Bloss, Managing Director for Delivery, the group is chaired by David Ball, Assistant Director of Environment Services and the Council Senior Officer for Housing and the Borough. In addition to myself, Joe and David, the group has senior representatives from Asset Management, Emergency Planning, Merseyside Fire and Rescue Services, Housing, Building Control, Magenta Living and the Press and PR. Others will be added to this group as and when required. For example, private high-rise owners will be invited. This group will meet formally every 2 weeks and is working on a 24/7 basis to deal with any issues which arise. This group is linked directly into the Homes and Communities Agency and the DCLG. High rise is defined as a building over 6 stories or 18 metres in height. There are 16 premises identified in Wirral as falling within this definition. 8 properties are owned and managed by Magenta Living, and 10 properties are in private ownership. The Council does not own or manage any high-rise accommodation. Magenta Living have been working very proactively with their tenants and Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service to assess the properties they own and to provide reassurance. The Council has been contacting the private owners of properties to do the same. No aluminium cladding has been found on Magenta-owned properties, and the inspections of the privately owned properties, which will be completed by the end of this week, to date has not identified any aluminium type cladding being used. The Council is also receiving a number of inquiries directly from elected members and members of the public as it is dealing with these on an individual basis. Inspecting properties where there are concerns with the Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service and providing reassurances. The Council will be issuing, in partnership with Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service and Magenta Living, regular updates on the work as it moves forward. And we are updating on emergency plans in light of the events to Camden, etc., just in case. So that's the conclusion at present moment for where we are.
Okay, thanks, George. I mean, clearly events are moving quite fast in terms of inspections, etc., going on. I'm very keen that we get as much information out to the public as possible to reassure them. To that end, I'm keen that we have kind of regular updates and something on our website to because I know, as you say, we're having a number of inquiries from members of the public. I'd like something going to go out this week to all elected members to give them the up-to-date situation. And crucially, and I know you're making this point, George, the landlords need to get clear messages out to their tenants in these blocks, exactly what the position is. I know you're talking to the landlords to make sure that happens. So, and I will undertake to keep it briefed the leaders of the groups on the council as well. So hopefully, everybody should be completely up to speed on where this position is up to. So I think we just need to give as many reassurances as we can. But we are proactively working on this, and it is the very kind of top of our list of priorities at the moment because of the anxiety that I absolutely understand what people have. So I think it's important just to kind of make that statement. Okay, well, thanks very much. Right, let's go into the agenda for this morning. So item two, the minutes from the last meeting. Can we agree that I sign them as a true record? Okay, item three is the executive key decisions taken under delegated powers, whether or not. So that takes us then to cabinet member reports. The first one is item four, the financial monitoring outturn reports for 2016-2017, pages 1 to 40 on your agenda. I'm going to ask cabinet member Janette Williamson to introduce this, please, Janette.
Thanks, Phil. Revenue reports have come to Cabinet throughout the last financial year, which showed an improving financial position for the Council. I'm pleased to tell you that the final report shows a relatively small underspend of £2.9 million, which will be used to mitigate the cuts coming our way in future years. I think it's a great achievement given the financial situation of Wirral Council, as well as a lot of other Northern Councils are having to operate under the austerity enforced upon them. So I'm really pleased that we've come in with that underspend. We've put money into adults and children's services in recognition of the rising demands and pressures placed on them. This fits in with the Wirral pledges, particularly those around people and environment, including supporting older people with well and supporting children through school and into work. Increasing income is key to the Council, and we're continually looking for opportunities to do so. Our proactive approach to Treasury management has delivered us £9.4 million worth of savings. It's essential that we hold monies and balances in the event of unforeseen circumstances and ensure we depreciate that increase in returns. Our balances have remained at £10 million, which is good news and in line with the Director of Finance recommendations. Regarding our reserves, these are sorts of money we held for specific purposes, and include money's help on behalf of schools. These have decreased from £74 million to £55 million, which is more good news. It means that we're not sitting on our money, but using it instead where it's needed to support specific projects and support the animal budget. Our capital outturn is £25 million. Capital spend is a major investment and one of projects that help deliver our pledges. Examples include the Wirral Eastern, the Hive, Dock Bridge replacement, sports centres and roads. I'm sure my colleagues will expand upon this after I finish speaking.
Thanks, Chair. Just to kind of identify a couple of big messages, key messages there. Great that we've balanced the budget, coming with the balanced budget, a small underspend, but that will absolutely be used to mitigate the savings that we need to make in this financial year, which you know, is another challenging year ahead. I'm also very pleased that our collection rate is up on council tax, and also our collection rate is up on business rates. I think that is good news, because the more income that we bring in, obviously that will go to towards funding services going forward. And then the third point I wanted to make is the importance of the capital programme to meet the pledges, the 20 pledges, you know, those key projects, some of which you just mentioned. That money is being used to deliver the Wirral plan. I think that's important. Important that we continue to bear down on budget. I hope that we might see a relaxation of austerity, but you know, we'll wait and see. But in the meantime, we've got some difficult decisions to make this year. But I think on the whole, in terms of 16-17, it's a good report, and you know, it shows that we are managing the council's finances. Any other questions? Chris?
Yes, thanks, Will. Thanks for that report, Janette. I just wanted to flag up the remarkable work that's been done by the investments in our rural youth zone. We supported that in partnership with the private and the voluntary sector. And the success is staggering, because the initial aim was to have 1,000 young people signed up to be members of the hive. We've already hit the target, they've already surpassed the target by 4 times. 4,000 children and people have now signed up to be members of the hive, and anyone who hasn't been there should go and visit it, because what you're seeing is an inspirational piece of work, which is really so hitting all our targets and our pledges around children and young people. So really great to see that even in these trying, difficult times, we are managing to do something just amazing.
Yeah, thanks for that, Chris. George?
I was just going to use the same part. I think Chris is absolutely, if I can just add to that what she just said about the hive, I think the numbers themselves do indicate it, I think, but I've never seen it in all my life. The only thing people of my age group say, I'd say, where were these things when I was looking? But it is, without a shadow of a doubt, the world's last facility. And one that I'm very, very proud of is sitting on the road. And the other point I just wanted to make, point about Phil, was the maximising the use of assets to the refurbishment of council buildings leads to more effective use and the release of surplus buildings. I think that's something that we really do need to concentrate on. It gives us a golden opportunity over the coming years, next year, 4 years, to get us to a position where stuff that is not being used and utilised in the proper manner, it can be altered and changed. And a good, great example is where we see the police and the fire and everybody else all start to use our own buildings, utilising the system. I think it's an excellent way forward. And there are some of the options. The improvement works to the bridge network is something that is essential if we're going to have rural waters effective over the years to come. I know it's an inconvenience to a lot of people at this present moment in time, but I believe 1 year out of the bridges being completed will bring a new dimension to the world. So thank you, Bill.
I suspect you may have stolen some of the highways, but Stuart, you wanted to come in.
Thanks, Bill. I just want to highlight the capital program, the highway schemes on page 22, the £4.2 million investment. Which includes £500,000 of our own capital money, which is the result of 39 services schemes, 16 for Wallasey being constructed, and 25 other schemes. Another highlight is the work we've been doing
5, which is the Treasury Management Monitoring Report for 16-17, the year-end report. So, Janette,
thank you. I'd just like to thank all my colleagues for their support and just shows how this council has delivered, is delivering on its pledges to help the older people out of those short term in the most testing of times. I'd just like to add that whilst I'm pulled out some of the austerity, my scheme reversed. I'm not going to help the rest, so I just think we should give ourselves a pass on the back. And I'll move straight on to our Treasury Management Report. I've just given an update of my first report, which highlighted the significant contribution Treasury Management made to the Council's financial position. This report provides the details in relation to Treasury Management activities, which cover the management of the cash position on a day-to-day basis, borrowing to minimise the cost to the Council and investments to increase income to the Council. We've saved £2.4 million by using internal funds to save on external borrowing. We're always looking for new and innovative approaches to Treasury management, and this includes reprofiling while we pay our debt repayments, which has generated a one-off saving of £7 million. With regards to investment markets generally, they're currently depressed, I suspect in part due to Brexit and the uncertainty that's brought. Return from the banks is low as well. Wirral rate of return on investments was 0.5% in 2016-17. Whilst I recognise that investments are important, risks need to be assessed and security of our investments is paramount. We can't be responsible for pulling them. I ask members to note the recommendations contained in this report. Thank you.
Thanks, Jeanette. And just to add to that, I mean, I think the, you know, the saving of 9.4 million is a really good outcome.
Yes.
Sometimes the work of our Treasury Management team isn't emphasised enough, but they do fantastic work in making sure that they manage our money really well. And I think this is an excellent example of the great team that we've got there to come up with such an impressive result, which really helps us to deal with the financial challenges we've got around the savings. So well done to the Treasury Management team. I think it's a really good outcome from their work. And obviously we'll be looking for this to continue in the next financial year because we have another difficult financial set of challenges to meet. But this is the 16-17 report. You can see the recommendations on page... Sorry, just before I move to recommendations, any questions anybody wants to amend to the chapter to raise? Okay, so I ask you to look at the recommendations on page 42, that the Treasury Manager Annual Report be for 16-17 be agreed, and that the saving of 9.4 million from the capital financing activities be noted. So can we accept those recommendations and agree?
Agreed.
Okay, thank you very much. Thanks, Jeanette. Okay, that takes us then to item number 6, which is the Coastal Strategy Scrutiny Review. I think, Phil, you're going to introduce this, and then we've got the chair of the Scrutiny Review, Councillor Mike Sullivan, who will take us to the report. Do you want to say a few words before we ask Mike to address the panel?
Thank you, Chair. Just to say that I was very grateful to be in position as Chair of the Environment and Scrutiny Committee last year, recommend this forward to have it for me to consider and later I should show you all that. But it wasn't actually me who conducted this work, it was Mike Sullivan, Councillor David Mitchell and Councillor John Hale, and I want to put my thanks on record for them for what is an excellent piece of work. And I want to ask Mike to come across and if she said if you can. Thank you.
Thank you, Phil. Now in 2010 the policies for how we manage these defences were set out in a shoreline management plan agreed by Cabinet. But policies in themselves can only be applied if there is a strategy for implementation. The Wirral Coastal Strategy looks at how policies for coastal defences can be delivered over the lifetime of the plan. And the lifetime of this plan is 100 years. The strategy looks at implementation over the short term, which takes us up to 2030. Medium term takes us up to from 2030 to 2060. And the long term plan takes us up to 2110. I think a couple of younger members of the cabinet might still be here then. Climate change is taken into account, and the recommended management of the coastal defences changes over the course of the next 100 years. The coastal strategy looks carefully at all issues around our coastal defence, including social, environmental and economic factors, and identifies a preferred sustainable management action to deliver policy. This may be, for example, to continue with existing maintenance, or it may be to reconstruct defences to an improved standard at some point in the future. But what we must bear in mind with this is finances, like everything else. And with all the cuts we've suffered, certainly since 2010, I must ask it to be noted that it's made our job infinitely more harder, infinitely harder, because of the cuts. The coastal strategy provides a strong framework for the management of flood erosion and risk around our coast, and also identifies recommendations where investment and intervention is needed in the short term to ensure risk to people and property is managed effectively. And I think we saw that during the last bout of inclement weather we had. Tremendous pressure was put on our coast, and I think it also should be noted that the council acted very, very well. There was lessons to be learned for sure, but I think having done this review, I'm confident as chair of the committee that did this, that the lessons are being learned and are being implemented. The coastal strategy also acknowledges the likely difficulties in securing funding for future coastal defence scheme, given the current funding arrangements for grant aid. The task and finish review investigated the challenges ahead in delivering the coastal strategy and included the following recommendations: that all available funding opportunities should be explored to support the delivery of schemes prior to consideration of internal capital bids. It was also recommended that the local levy can provide a source for this funding. I'd also like to mention the local levy. It's a levy that all councils pay in the Merseyside area, and I'd like it also to be noted that Wirral does particularly well. The other councils in our area, and it argues well for the future, the other councils within the Merseyside city region recognise our unique position here, and when the levy is being issued out, we in Wirral
So I'll just ask Phil as the cabinet member to come back, say a few words, and I'll open it up to others.
Thank you, Phil. Thank you, Mike. Again, it's an excellent report. Stay here if you want, Mike. It's up to you. I recommend that the cabinet supports all the recommendations contained in this report. Really, not to act and put a strategy in place now is to really limit and undermine our ability to withstand any instance of care in the future. With that said, I would yet just say the final recommendations on page 62. I'd be grateful if you all agree to support.
Okay, before we do that,
anybody
want to add anything to the discussion? No? Okay, so.